So I would like to introduce ourselves. Our names are Marianne Bonberger and
Peter Bonberger.
And we both are from Ulm in Germany. We are the founders of the international charitable non-profit organization Bear Springs Blossom Nature Conservation.
In Ulm, just a block away from the place I was born, Albert Einstein was born, and we like to start our presentations with a saying of Albert Einstein. This one is short, but true. So today, a presentation about the Atlantic Ocean, the ocean we sail on now for, I think, 9 days.
And of course, there are very many, many interesting things to talk about the Atlantic Ocean. So we will talk about the size, where the name comes from. We will talk about the early explorers and some of the adventurers. We will also show you some nature and, of course, the marine life. And we will show a few photos about the ports we have been visiting.
We always like to ask you questions, and start with one.
And we really need your participation. So, do you know how much of Earth's surface is covered by oceans?
Absolutely, yes. Correct. 71% of all surface is covered by oceans.
And you might know that life on Earth started in the seas, and our oceans continue to be the home of an incredibly diverse web of life.
A little bit statistic here. On this graphic, we show you that all water on Earth is, most of it, in the oceans, 97.41%. Then we have a little sliver there with 2.5%, and that's all the fresh water, groundwater, ice caps, glaciers. And then the last sliver here is 0.014%. And that's the water that is readily accessible to us as drinking water. And in the plant life, biota, in the rivers, in the atmospheric vapor, means clouds, and the lakes. So we cannot really access a huge amount of the water that's on Earth. The NASA is providing us, our group, with a lot of information. Our vice president works for 30 years with NASA. And NASA got a lot of information about what's out there. And we know now that our Earth is very, very unique in our solar system, because we have liquid water. Other planets have water too, but frozen, or sometimes liquid water under a thick layer of ice. Just yesterday, Curiosity reported from Mars that they found their empty riverbed. So there was water running on Mars, but that was a long time ago.
So that leads us to the question, why then does Earth have water? Where does the water on Earth come from?
Did you ever think about that? For millions and millions and billions of years, Earth was bombarded by asteroids. And again, from NASA and from other space agencies, we know that these asteroids contain water. Between 15 and 50, 70, 80, 90% of water is in these asteroids. And when they have bombarded Earth, the water stayed on Earth. In the beginning, when Earth was very hot, there was no chance that the water stayed on Earth. But as Earth cooled down, the water could stay and was filling up our gaps, our bringing up our oceans.
And these asteroids contain heavy hydrogen, and exactly the same heavy hydrogen is found in our oceans, and that suggests a common origin. So there's another question. Where does the name ocean come from?
Never thought about
it? Just give it a guess. Doesn't matter if it's not the perfect answer.
What you see here is the god Okeanos, the Greek god Okeanos. And you see the similarity of the names. So the Greeks knew about their own ocean, that was the Mediterranean Sea, and they used the word ocean for all the waters that did not belong to the Mediterranean Sea, everything outside of the Strait of Gibraltar. And they believe that outside there is a gigantic river, and you see it here on the graphic, that what they thought is all around them, a gigantic river encircling the world.
So that was their imagination or their knowledge about the earth. Now we know more about the oceans, and now we know about the world oceans. And the world ocean has an area of 140 million square miles.
When we went to school, I learned in school that there are four oceans, four major oceans out there. But
then in spring in 2000, another ocean was named. You see it here on the globe, the Southern Ocean. It was named by the International Hydrographic Organization.
So, to bring it closer to the end, the Atlantic Ocean. We try to inform you where the name comes from.
We talked about the size, that it's the second largest ocean.
We explained a little bit of the geology.
And we showed you, or we talked about the explorers and some of the adventurers who crossed the Atlantic Ocean.
All the creatures that are under us by the millions.
We talked about the islands that are located in the Atlantic Ocean. And at the end, we showed you some of the ports we have visited. And we hope you can have more ports to visit on your next cruise. It's wonderful and it's worth the effort.
So thank you very much for sailing with us and coming to our presentations. And we hope that you enjoyed our presentations and this cruise. And we hope we will see you again on another ship. Thank you very much. Thank you for coming.
And we also want to thank you for your friendly and nice comments you gave us when you met us on deck. So keep talking to us. We enjoy it. Thank you very much and enjoy the rest of the trip. Goodbye and the best.